You know, it's a small world, isn't it? But it's not. It's huge, it's exciting, and it's full of wonders. And each one of us are shaped by our own experiences. My experiences started in Toppenish, Washington, which is a small town in a fruit valley, much like the Okanagan. And I had a typical middle-class American upbringing, which is like you see on social media where somebody will post a picture and it says, do you remember this? Or do you know what this is? Or my favorite. When we were kids, we survived drinking out of a garden hose. But I did have a good life, but I was just so excited when I got out of school because I wanted to go somewhere where life is more exciting. So I moved to San Diego, California. Life is more exciting in San Diego, California. Then there were still orange groves between Los Angeles and San Diego, and east of San Diego was still open desert. Well, I went to Tijuana, I went to Disneyland, I went to Whiskey A Go Go in Hollywood. I got kissed by Shamu. I got to tour a nuclear submarine, the USS Scorpion. I saw President Nixon, Clint Eastwood, Elton John. I got to go to professional baseball games, and I even got to swim in the ocean on Christmas Day because I could. I met my husband, John Mudie, when I was living in San Diego, and at the time, he was living in Yellowknife in the Northwest Territories. So I packed up all my stuff in the back of his pickup, and off we went to Yellowknife. That was quite a change between the Mexican border and the Arctic Circle. And the Northwest Territories at that time were 3.5 million square kilometers in area with a population of less than 43,000 people. The Northern Lights are breathtaking. I got to mush a dog team. I got to go on an underground tour of a working gold mine. I saw fire on ice, literally, because they had caribou carnival. They had a huge bonfire going on in the making of the lake. I got to drive over ice roads and fly over migrating caribou herds. We even spent one summer up in Inuvik, which is up by the Arctic Ocean. And in a 24-hour period, the sun just made a tight little circle above your head. The Great White North is beautiful, but it's very cold. So in the early 80s, we moved to Parksville, in just the islands, and we thought it would be a great place to raise our family, and we lived there almost 20 years. But when we were living in Parksville, I got a job at an insectary. An insectary is an insect nursery, basically. We raise good bugs that ate bad bugs as an alternative to chemical pest control. Now, I was hired as the bookkeeper, but I fell in love with the insects. They are fascinating creatures. And within a couple of years, I moved into sales. My territory was Vancouver Island, Southern California, and Nevada. I did biological pest control for some of the biggest casinos in Las Vegas, for strawberry growers, raspberry growers, greenhouse growers in Southern California, and here on the island for cranberry growers, greenhouse growers, egg producers, and even a llama farm. I loved my job. After 9 years, though, the company ran into some financial difficulties. So I left the company. But after I left the company, one of my clients from Southern California called, and he offered me a job I couldn't refuse. So our kids grew up, and John and I left home. We moved to Thermal, California, which is in the Mojave Desert. It's about an hour east of Palm Springs on the shores of the Salton Sea. Now, North Shore Greenhouses at that time was raising culinary herbs and long English cucumbers. I was hired as the grower and the IPM manager, and IPM stands for Integrated Pest Management. I told Leo before he hired me, I'm not a grower. He goes, that's okay, you will be. I actually did become a fairly successful greenhouse grower, because before I left North Shore, I was growing over 6 million herb plants a year, plus the cucumbers, and the company's revenue had increased 5.5-fold. I also developed and implemented the food safety program. That's where I was in January. They had asked me to come down and help them prepare for their food safety audit, which is global standards, and we got 100%. So when John and I first went down there, we thought, oh, we'll be there about 5 years maybe. Well, I was coming on 11 years, and we decided it was definitely time to move back to Canada. So we came to Victoria. So I don't know if Victoria is the end of my journey, but I've had people ask me many times, how did you do that? How did you just get up and, you know, go move so far away? But how could I not? Life was out there just waiting for me to come and live it. So I did, with no regrets.